Good morning. Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here to judge your jersey show today. We've got an outstanding calf to start the winter calf class here. A calf that just combines the dairiness, the strength, the beautiful cage, and walking on an excellent set of feet and legs. It's that blending of parts and tremendous spring of rib that places her over the second calf. Also, she's a little more clean cut all the way through. The second calf, a little too thick for me, but she excels in size and scale and power, and she handles herself more nicely on her hind legs than the third calf. It's a calf in second with flat, clean bone. A calf that's just been pushed a little too much at this stage of the game, and she'll come along, I think, in that regard as far as the dairiness. But it's the advantage in legs and depth of rear rib that places her over the dairy calf we have in third. Third over fourth, primarily advantage in spring of rib. She's just much... has much more spring to that rib when you get behind him than the dairy calf we have in fourth. And fourth over fifth, she's a little tighter behind the shoulder, a little wider at the pins.
No, I'm just saying that. What do you want to get? No. What do you want to get? Safari, right? Yeah, a little compass thing. Or Firefox, whatever you want to use. Safari. Yep. All we have to do is make sure you upload and you're done before I take the pictures. That way we don't cancel each other out and we're working on the same account.
Congratulations to your winner of class number 3 and the winner number 5. good morning. Good morning, everybody. Really, really nice class of December calves to start the red and white show. And for me, quite a handy winner. I really admire this calf. She's not the biggest calf. But
Thank you.
What a beautiful class of fall calves here in the Jersey ring. A calf I'm starting with, not the largest calf in the class, but plenty big enough and just so well balanced. She has an advantage in depth for both fore and rear rib over my second calf. Just a little more pleasing at the tail head than the second calf. But I love that second calf for her uphill walk, the daringness, the flashiness about her calf that's got a lot of upside to her as well. Second over third, it's that prominence of chine, it's that style that carries her over the calf in third. A little more dairy all the way through than the calf in third also. A little more clean cut through the front end. Third over fourth, we just have a little more substance throughout. She has more depth of heart and width of chest than the real well-balanced calf we have in fourth. This is the fourth calf, the youngest calf in the class, and I just love her for her dairiness and her balance throughout. She places over the next calf on that dairiness that she has, being cleaner over the withers, hips, and pins, and flatter in her thigh than the fifth calf. The fifth calf, another correctly made calf that has the advantage over the calf following her on the way she handles herself on her hind legs. But I moved this next calf up a bit. Just love the cage on this heifer. Just like to change the wheels a little bit to move her any higher.
Okay.
I go fast. Fresh.
Well, just an amazing fall calf class here for the spring show and the spring level. I got calves all the way down the line. I love. I got two big calves on the end. The two boys. I told them. The heifer in first, she's ready to show today. This heifer is extremely balanced. She's extremely clean. She's got a beautiful head and neck. And viewed from the rear, she tracks perfectly on her rear set of legs. And that's the advantage I gave her over the nice, stylish calf that matches her in second. Calf in second, another extreme length of frame calf. Another calf that's got a beautiful head and neck. Calf I admire when she stands. But I give her an advantage of walking more correctly on her front legs when I view the big heifer, the red heifer in third. Heifer in third, another extreme length of frame dairy calf. Beautiful rib calf. Watching on move from the front view, her toes turn just out enough that I give the nod to the second place calf. And a calf in third, another extreme dairy calf. Another calf with a beautiful head and neck. Another calf is a little longer in her frame than the big rib calf I have in fifth. A calf in fifth. Beautiful calf, just like a length in her frame, a length in her head and neck to get above the calf head.
You. You're right. No problem.
You do.
That's what's kind of nice.
You'll see it. Must have brought some salient.
Thank you.
Wow, just another great class of calves. And at the top, we've got a close pair. But the calf in first, she's wider in her chest floor, she's wider in her rump, she's more balanced than the pretty long red heifer we have in second. Heifer in second, I really love the heifer. She's really flashy beside you. But when you stand behind her, she just doesn't have the width of the rump or the width of the hips to get over the calf in first. Calf in second over the calf in third, the way she puts her rear feet down. The calf in third, I really admire the calf in third. Another long-range dairy calf. I'd like to change the way she puts her rear feet down to get any higher. Third over fourth, way she handles her top. I'd like to have her fourth a lot. She just needs to tighten up in the shoulder region and up to her, the way she carries her head and neck to get any higher. Another nice calf in fifth. Just doesn't have the extreme parts as the heifers are.
Just a tremendous class of summer yearlings here in the Jerseys. Outstanding heifer to start the class. A heifer with so much length and stretch and style and dairiness. It's that length and stretch that carries her over the heifer in second. The heifer in second, I admire for her openness of rib, her cleanness through the front end. She's a little cleaner through the neck and throat than the well-balanced heifer we have in third. The third heifer over fourth on openness primarily. She's just a little more open than a rib, just shows me a little more dairy quality today than the real strong calf we have in fourth here, a calf that's real straight in her lines. And this fourth calf has an advantage the way she handles herself on her hind legs over the roach top calf we have in fifth. Admittedly, this calf in fifth, a little bit of a problem for me. The roach top is good. I'd just like to see the calf a little deeper in the rear rib maybe to move her any higher. But she was a problem for me in this class. But it's that extreme length and size and scale substance that places her over the calf following it next in line. Then we come down with some real dairy calves, not as large as some of the others in the class, but very correct in their conformation and good quality right on down through the line.
you to act busy.
I
Just another great class of spring yearling heifers here, and a heifer that I always place on the top. The heifer in first just extremes in dairy quality and dairy strength. I love the strength of this heifer. She's wide chested, and it is the way she tracks on the rear legs, just a touch. I'm being critical over the heifer in second. Heifer in second, I really admire too. When she keeps herself together, I love this heifer a lot. Matches my heifer in first, just doesn't track quite as nice as the heifer in first to get any higher. Second over third on that length of frame. Heifer in third, I really admire her squareness, her side profile. She's just lacking over the length of frame to get any higher. Third over fourth on her springer rib, depth of rib. Heifer in fourth, I really admire the dairiness, the dairy quality of this heifer, just lacking overall mass of the rib structure. Then a heifer in fifth. Heifer fifth, problem heifer in the class. I love this heifer. This heifer's big, strong, wide, love her head and neck. Just would like to change her from her hips back. I'd like to flatten her out in the rump and the way she sets her feet down to get any higher. Congratulations.
Better spring yearling class here, an outstanding group again in the Jersey ring. I think a heifer that handles the class quite handily for me. She combines the straightness and hardness of top over our second place calf with the correctness all the way through. I think she handles herself just a trifle nicer on her hind legs than this calf in second. This calf in second, a close placing second and third to me. I switched them back and forth. Standing in line, I like the third heifer better, but out on the move, we just love the cage of this second heifer. It's that depth of heart, depth of chest, and openness and depth of rear rib that places her over the tall, long heifer in third. Heifer in third, I think you just love her for her uphill walk, her length of body, her dairiness all the way through. But not quite the rib development, a little two heifers above her. But it's that dairiness and flashing us that carries her over the very correct heifer we have in fourth. The fourth heifer, the youngest heifer in the class. A very well-balanced heifer, just not quite as dairy as the one above her. But it's that depth of rear rib and openness of rib that places her over the long heifer in fifth. Fifth over sixth on correctness of hind legs.
I'm not putting the one that was asleep. And I got your brother right here. That's just who's down there. Thank you. humans.
Another great group of heifers out here, and an exceptional heifer, just a great heifer in every way. The heifer lead on first, she's got a beautiful side profile, she's got a wide chest, she's got a wide rump, she's deep ribbed, she's ultra dairy, and I just love everything about this heifer, taking nothing away from the heifer in second. Just a little bit more extreme up through her head and neck, a little wider in her rump, and a little wider at the chest when you view them from the front. Second over third is on her overall length of frame. She's a little longer, a little leaner than heifer in third. Heifer in third, I love the way her parts blend. I love everything about the heifer, just not the extremeness of the first two heifers. Heifer in fourth, another really well-made heifer again. A heifer I'd like to clean out, especially over the pen region to get any higher. Fourth over fifth is the way the pens are set. I love this heifer in fifth. I love the ultra dairy quality. I love the front end. I love the head and neck. Just like to drop the pens just to touch them. Congratulations.
our winter yearlings here in New Jersey's. A couple nice heifers at the top of this class. The heifer I'm starting with, just a little more springer grip, a little cleaner cut through the neck and throat than our second place heifer, but a fairly close pair. Second over third, primarily in the advantage of strength to top line. She's much harder through her loin, more correct from hooks to pins than the dairy heifer we have in third. But it's that dairiness that places this heifer in third where she is. She's so much more open than her ribbing than the heifer in fourth. The heifer in fourth, a little disadvantage today, not walking quite right, but a heifer that we're going to put her in that fourth slot, giving her an advantage in dairiness all the way through over the heifer in fifth. She's also a little longer, more nearly level from hooks to pins than the heifer in fifth. Fifth over six on strength to top line and blending of parts.
Yeah, I think you're right. Thank you.
First, she's a little bit longer in her frame. She's a little bit longer. She's actually a little wider in her rump than the heifer in second. The heifer in second, she's got power. She's got mass. She's got a little side profile. But I just prefer the rump, the width of the rump on the heifer in first and the length of frame over the heifer in second. Second over third on the overall mass, on the overall rib structure. The beautiful heifer we have in third, she's made rib very correctly, just doesn't have the power to get any higher. Third over fourth, on the way she handles her rear legs, just a little bit more balanced, a little harder over top than her front foot. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Championships record or 5-time I'll do it. I can add in just the things.
Let's give these youth exhibitors a big round of applause. Just an amazing group of heifers out here, heifers I left behind, and four that, to me, just excel in everything I'm looking for. They all have good feet and legs. They all are blending in their parts. They're all ultra dairy with pretty head and necks. Our first place December calf, by far not the biggest calf in the class, just so well bound, so hardy, so lean, so long, so dairy. Our September calf, a calf that's just amazing. Beautiful side profile. She's got the width to go along with the balance and depth of rib and a beautiful head and neck. A summer yearling that I just admire. I admire her dairiness, her stretch of frame, a pretty head and neck, beautiful feet and legs. Our spring yearling, a big, strong, heifer that's going to make a great cow someday. When it came down to junior champion, the heifer that put it all together for me was this first place fall calf. Just a heifer, I admire every part of this heifer. She's so pretty head and neck, so beautiful side profile, and she's got a rib structure. Maybe you could say it was splitting hairs, but not for me. But the summer yearling is going to be your reserve if you pull your summer yearling out. A heifer that excels in the length of frame and ultra dairy quality and honorable mention is going to be your first place December calf. Congratulations.
What a great class of fall yearlings here. There's not a bad heifer in the class, all the way down. And sometimes we use a little rhetoric on the microphone, but in this case, it's true. This is the deepest class that you could imagine. Good ones all the way through. That being said, the heifer that I started the class with, not the largest heifer, but just picture perfect. Just correct in every way. She's straight. She's a little longer from hooks to pins than the heifer in second. Just a little more. A little freer in walking on her hind legs than the heifer in second. Just a little neater over the rump region of the tail head, a little longer from hips to pins than the heifer in second. But that big, powerful heifer in second, it's that tremendous depth of fore rib and spring of rib that places her over the heifer in third. A fairly close placing, but I just thought the tremendous cage on this heifer in second, I couldn't deny her that spot. Third over fourth, primarily an advantage in the way she handles herself on the hind legs, just tracks a little nicer than the long heifer we have in fourth. Fourth over fifth, primarily on the strength of loin, she's just a little stronger, harder top, a little longer from head to tail than the deep rib heifer we have in fifth. Fifth over sixth on depth of rear flank, and a little more dairy inner ribbing than the heifer following her. Real nice class all the way through.
Thank you.
first. I need all the help I can get. I'm just learning.
Thank you.
Let's give our junior exhibitors a big hand here. They've competed pretty well in a really tough show this morning. For junior champion, I pulled out my two fall calves and my two fall yearlings. I think the fall yearlings didn't place real high in their class, but that just goes to show the quality that we had in class, because when you get this group out here, those are two heifers that stand out in this group to me. For junior champion, I'm going to give the nod to my first prize fall yearling, just a little more drop to rib than my reserve champion, which will be my fall calf. Two outstanding individuals, made much the same way, straight in their lines, long in their rump, excellent in their feet and legs. Just two lovely heifers. So if you bring that fall yearling ahead a little bit, she'll be our junior champion. Our fall calf will be reserved. And for honorable mention, I give the nod to my second place fall yearling. Four outstanding individuals. Congratulations.
It's been quite a red heifer show, and I think these exhibitors are extreme. Give them a big round of applause. I applaud individuals that excel in everything I'm looking for. They got great feet and legs, they're well balanced, they're deep ribbed, they're ultra dairy heifers I really admire. Heifers I left behind that are going to have a big fall, but these are the ones that are here for today. First place fall calf, she's so well balanced, just head to tail. I just love her. She's pretty headed, pretty side profile. Pair of winter yearlings, big rib heifers, beautiful side profile, deep in her rib, wide in her rumps, and a pair of fall yearlings, just so big, so long, so lean, so dairy. But for me today, heifers all together, she blends from head to tail. Is going to be your first place fall yearling. And I'm going to follow up with the second place fall yearling. I give her the nod over the winter yearling. She's a little bit more blending in her parts. I like it over her neck. And she's a little bit longer in the frame, but a really good heifer show. Congratulations. just won in our red and white junior three-year-old, or yeah, junior best three class, but really nice group, really dairy, really deep, and really nice head and neck. Congratulations.
Let's give our jersey exhibitors a big hand for the quality we have out here. As a judge, I always say it's a lot easier to judge good cattle than it is lesser quality cattle. And certainly the lineup we have out here, you'd be glad to have most any of these as your junior champion of most shows. And I left aside some really good individuals here. But the four to me that most exemplify what I'm looking for as far as dairiness and openness of rib and depth and correctness of legs and straightness of lines are my winter calf, which is an outstanding individual, I feel, for her age. Just a tremendous upside to this calf. Just really look forward to seeing what she comes along with down the road. My spring yearling, a really flashy, deep rib. Lots of springer rib to this heifer, just so straight and stylish. And then our two outstanding fall yearlings, a class that I still haven't quite got over the quality of that class or the depth of it. And these two headed that up real well. My first prize heifer, you just love her for her correctness or flatness of rump and length of rump. And then our second prize fall yearling, just a little different kind of a heifer with her tremendous rib and depth and openness all the way through. For junior champion, the one heifer that most puts it together for me today is my spring yearling. She's going to be my junior champion. I just think this heifer is outstanding. When I first saw her, you just fall in love with her. And she has, I think, just a little more pop to her rib than my first prize fall yearling, which will be my reserve. And for honorable mention, will be my second prize fall yearling. The outstanding heifers, and congratulations to all.
She is our best out in the class, and that's what carries her to top. She's got an exceptional rudder for a young cow. She's got veins all over her rudder, and she's got a high ride in her rudder, and she's long and lean. I do grant the cow in second. I like the cow in second for the structure better than the cow in first. I like her mass, but the rudder on this one cow in first, but the shoulder body will go into this other. Second over third on that overall rib structure, overall mass. Nice cow in third, just not enough to get over the mass of this rib structure. Third over fourth on hyphen with her.
Thank you.
three outstanding groups. The first place group of three first place animals and then the champion, pretty hard to deny them. The second group, very uniform, a little more mature than our third group, more rib development, but a lot of ribbon power all the way down through the three groups.
That'd be fine. Just pull it up.